It's no secret that we're all on our phones a lot of the time. But there's a growing concern that too much screen time can have an effect on nearsightedness. Carolee McGrath explores what we can do to help save our eyesight in the digital age.
7-year-old Alexis Keough loves to read, loves to play with her friends, and loves her iPad. She's certainly not alone. According to Common Sense Media, the amount of time kids spend on mobile devices has tripled in recent years, from 15 minutes a day in 2013 to 48 minutes a day in 2017. And everything is at their fingertips, from games to movies.
I noticed, you know, that that's all they want to do. They don't want to play anymore. You buy them $1 million worth of toys and they just sit in a room and you get them to go outside and 10 minutes later they want to come back in. It's nothing like it was when we were growing up.
The more concerning problem for Mom Jen is how the close screen time could be affecting her little girl's eyesight. Alexis is nearsighted. She's a patient at Chicopee Eye Care.
I didn't think anything of it until coming here and finding out that definitely it makes sense because you're holding the thing so close to your face.
I've been in practice for almost 45 years, and I'm just seeing a lot more nearsightedness now than I did 20, 30 years ago. The statistics are showing a dramatic increase in myopia in this country and globally.
According to the American Optometric Association, people who do close work, reading on computers or staring at a screen, are more likely to be at risk of developing nearsightedness or myopia. It's a condition in which people can see up close, but have a harder time seeing far away. For example, a sign or a whiteboard in school could be blurry to someone who's nearsighted. Dr. David Momnie, an optometrist, says there are genetic factors that cause nearsightedness, but he also says environmental factors appear to be having an impact.
We know there are other factors involved. We know that children are spending a lot of time on digital devices, smartphones, iPads, computer games, Xbox. So we're not sure if it's just more close work or if the digital devices themselves are a factor. But one thing we can all do is try to limit the exposure.
Dr. Camille Latka is Dr. Momnie's partner at Chicopee Eye Care.
As time is going by, we're seeing an increase in the amount of nearsightedness worldwide. There's genetic reasons. You know, if you have a parent who's nearsighted, your odds of being nearsighted are 2 times greater than if you didn't have a parent with myopia. Or if both parents are, it can be 5 times greater. However, environmental reasons have an impact as well. Some, all the reading, close work, computer that we're doing, seems to be contributing to the increase in nearsightedness.
Dr. Momnie and Dr. Latka say that parents really need to limit screen time, which can be difficult if your teenagers are using their phones or computers for homework. But they also say to try the 20-20-20 rule.
For every 20 minutes of intense near work you're doing, try to look up and out at least 20 feet away for 20 seconds to not only give your eye muscles a break so that when you look out at distance they relax, but also you can do a few blinks. Another good rule of thumb is for every hour that you're on a near device like a computer, it's good to take a 10-minute break, walk away from it, do something else.
A study released by the Public Library of Science found that children in India who spent 7 hours a week on computers or mobile devices tripled their risk of myopia.
As we project forward to 2050, they're estimating that up to 50% of the population may become nearsighted worldwide, with 10% highly nearsighted.
Dr. Latka says high nearsightedness carries with it a risk of glaucoma, cataracts, a detached retina, and macular degeneration. In the meantime, Jen Keough is following the doctor's advice.
I give her time restrictions, and then once in a while I'll even unplug the internet or, you know, try to distract her or make outside plans, go do something or get away from the house, go shopping, do something other than when she's having too much time.